Right, I apologise for it being quite dark in here. It is night time.
What time is it?
5:45. And I've been sitting on the sofa wanting to do this for ages, but as I said before, when I come home from work, I'm usually pretty tired. I bought these the other day from B&M. As I say, I had a voucher. And these look pretty cool to me. And I had a little idea for a canvas. And I'm just going to start it today. This is just going to be a little bit of it. I'm not going to do the whole thing right now. I'm just going to start because I don't really know where it's going to go. I just know vaguely what I want to do. And the only problem with these is that I don't know where I'm going to put them now that I've opened it, because there's no lid or anything. I think I do want to double stack because they're actually quite thick. Okay. I have this idea of putting this word down and then just doing stuff on top and sort of ignoring the fact that the word's there, so that it becomes part of the canvas. So, I'm going to use my hot glue gun. I would normally not, because when the hot glue dries, it can be quite brittle and things can start to fall off. But because I'm going to be doing all sorts of stuff over the top, that will help hold it down as well. This is just for ease, really. Get that nice and lined up. I bought 2 packs of these letters because you only get 3 of each letter, which isn't great if you're going to be doing a lot of things like this, especially if you're going to double stack the letters. If you're just going to use one, then it's maybe not so bad, but if you write a word like believe, that's all your E's gone. This canvas is not particularly tight. It might be good if you could restretch it, but I don't know if I'm all that bothered. I'm hoping that when we start adding the layers, it will add a bit of strength and all that. Right. go. Let's get rid of some of these stringy bits. Stick to you. Right. I'm just going to give that a little chance to cool and set, and I'm going to unplug the glue gun, and I'll be back in 1 second with just a little bit more. Okay, so I have all these really nice tissue papers that I've had for a while and not used. So I'm just going to take a little bit. Take a bit of that off. And a little bit of this one. And maybe a bit of the butterfly one. Pretty. There we go. And now I'm going to grab a brush. I don't usually use a brush with my matte mediums and glues and things, but I need to get into the letters. And I'm going to have to. I don't think I'm going to need a lot of tissue paper, to be honest. Don't need to cover the entire background. I just need to add a little bit here and there for interest. Start the process of sort of pushing this into the background, so let's just pop that up there for a sec. Right, let's get some matte medium down. Stick that there. Paper molds nicely round the letters, and you can, it might sort of tear, but that doesn't really matter. Napkin would be very good for this too. I did think about using napkin, but most of my napkins are quite vintagey, and I'm not sure I really want to go vintage with this. I'm thinking quite abstract, and old, maybe. We shall see. You can see the canvas bouncing quite a bit, so yeah, that's interesting. Tuck it all in. Push it in. And it's kind of crumbling, falling apart, never mind. We'll just go with it. Just want to make sure that it's gonna not kind of make the letters lose their definition. I don't want them to just turn into big blobs on the canvas. Let's do some up here. Probably going to gesso over this to give us a nice subtle background. Let's go around the edge as well. That medium everywhere. And it's probably going to wrinkle and give us texture, and that is fine. It's all added interest. Let's get a little bit up here. Into the edges. That is that for the tissue paper. Get rid of some of this lumpy down here. Don't mind a bit of texture, but don't want it too lumpy really. Needs to be nice texture. There we go. Okay. Trying to spread out some of the matte medium that's collected around the letters. Okay, and I think that's it. I'm going to leave it now. I'll let it dry, and hopefully I'll be back with this soon. But I'll just upload this so you can see the start of the project, and it hopefully won't be too long then, because I think it's going to be a long process. This is sort of how I do my journal pages most of the time. I start them and then I go away and I have an idea for another project, so I'll work on that for a while and then come back to the journal page that I started, and yeah. So many projects on the go. Pink tissue paper is really nice around the letters. It's kind of hugged it, but the butterfly stuff is just sort of falling apart. There you go. This one's really nice as well. I really like the way that's, you can see the wood through it, but with the flowers on it. So I might see if we can just get a bit more of that on there. I know I said I was done. Can't stop playing now. This is quite a stiff brush. Ugh, no. Okay. It's not working. Trying to be sort of gentle, kind of easing it into the spaces. A little bit. Letting it stretch and fold and crease and do whatever it needs to get around the letters. Best stop there and I'll sort out the dinner and then I'll upload this and post it for you and all that. So hope you enjoy and I'll see you soon. Hope the light's not too bad. I've got my light thing on. Hopefully this camera will be better than my other one at handling the conditions. It's a bit of a test for the camera as well, this. See how good it is. I'm quite happy with it so far now that I've got my teething problems out the way. But yeah, anyway. Enough about that and I will see you soon.